The National Wild Turkey Federation has taken a focused approach to conservation through their America's Big Six of Wildlife Conservation. Six regions, encompassing 738 million acres, were identified to address the most urgent needs and better focus resources. These regions are America's Western Wildlands, America's Great Open Spaces, America's Crossroads, America's Mid-South Rebirth, America's Southern Piney Woods, and America's Colonial Forests. In these regions, the NWTF and its partners are taking conservation delivery to a whole new level.
To talk about conservation in the West and not talk about water is just conversation, because water in the West is really life. I think it's a great opportunity not only for me but for the NWTF to now bring the water resource conversation into the great conservation work that the NWTF is doing.
I look at the pictures and I think, how in the world did we get here? How did we get to a point that the forest is so thick that you can't see 75 feet off of the forest road? 40 years ago, this was in a ponderosa pine forest, and you could probably see for a half or three quarters of a mile through those big towering pine trees. Natural fire had been on that landscape. Natural fire had taken care of the ground fuels. Natural fire had thinned it to where the trees could be healthy.
The Rocky Mountain Restoration Initiative is a unique project, and Colorado, as a headwater state, as a hub of the West for outdoor recreation, iconic wildlife habitat, and people here investing and understanding the issues that we're facing. And we're hoping that this initiative really can be a model for what one approach for how we might address landscape scale restoration across boundaries. And that's why we have to all be working together to really understand each other's priorities and focus in those places to help each other be successful.
The foundation of a guide day, you need to be able to find fish. You need to be able to teach. And in the biggest of the picture, you really need to be a steward of the land. When you're looking at our forests and how they're managed from recreation, our job as fly fishing guides, as an outfitter, is to be able to teach conservation, to be able to share through experience that these amazing places that we share have importance.
The Rocky Mountain Restoration Initiative is really now advocating the pre-fire mitigation efforts. What can communities do before the fire shows up? The Rocky Mountain Restoration Initiative and bringing other partners for long-term funding is the key to the pre-fire mitigation and preparing not only our landscapes and the wildlife habitat and the water supplies, but the downstream communities at risk. And it will take the downstream communities and all of us in the West coming together to make this successful.
One thing that I have really looked at and found very interesting is the fact that 40 years ago, we used to talk about the possibility of a big fire coming to our community. 2002, we had the 70,000 acre Missionary Ridge Fire, which was on the east side of the canyon here. And then in 2018, we had the 50,000 acre 416 fire that was on the other side of the canyon. So when you evaluate all of that acreage that burned in La Plata County, there's significant impacts that take place on the community. Those larger fires really do create a lot of destruction, obviously, when they burn out the way these fires burned out. They're very hot, very intense, basically taking all of the vegetation from all of the mountains and all of the canyons. we're all starting to worry and starting to look very critically at what's going on with our water supplies. And right now we're in a position, looking at the Animas River this last year was extremely low. A lot of people depend on water out of that watershed. And when we start burning out these huge watershed areas, and the water that comes from those watersheds brings so much sediment and so much ash, it destroys the ability for people to use the water in the stream. And I think that what we have to do, from my personal view, is that we have to change the way we've been doing business, obviously. It's not working, and it hasn't worked. We have to protect the water quality that we have. It's that simple.
Fire threat that's facing the West is not a small problem, and it's getting bigger and bigger each year. It's a different type of fire than we've seen in the past. These are really high intensity fires. They're devastating homes. They're burning watersheds. They're impacting wildlife habitat. And what that looks like is, how do we start to address a problem at a scale that's hundreds of thousands of acres? The thought came, what would you do if you had more time? So if we knew that fire was going to hit in a place, what could you do in 10 years? And what would you do first? And that is one of the core concepts behind the Rocky Mountain Restoration Initiative, is how do we go with urgency, the same urgency as if you're a firefighter out on the front lines today, out in one of these fires in California or Colorado or wherever. The first thing is, you need a partner in that. And the Forest Service has worked with the National Wild Turkey Federation for many, many years. It's one of our longest standing partners. And the chief of the Forest Service and the CEO of the National Wild Turkey Federation got together and challenged the agencies to do more. What could we do to do more out there on this landscape to mitigate this threat? Looking at all these issues, the next thing you have to do is you have to call a lot more people. Because if you're talking about what are you going to do over 10 years, you're going to need a lot of help. You're going to need help from our partners at the state, our local agencies, local watershed collaboratives, wildlife groups, NGOs. You're going to need everyone to pitch in if you're really going to make a difference. And that's really been a challenge, but I think we've come a long way in terms of defining what a shared vision looks like at the right scale. Right now in Colorado, for example, on average, between insects and disease and wildfire, the state is impacted almost 400,000 acres a year, and we're treating at a rate 30 to 50,000 acres a year. And so we're just not keeping up, right? We're not getting there. And so what the initiative is trying to do is, rather than spreading resources, it's resources thin all over a bunch of places, it's saying, let's all collectively invest what we can in a few places. And like right here in the Southwest, our landscape is about 800,000 acres and it includes three independent watersheds. And we're looking at trying to treat over 300,000 acres over the next 10 years. And what that treatment looks like is a combination of using prescribed fire, thinning and forest improvements. It's addressing recreation issues. It's improving wildlife habitat. And so it's a combination of things that will roll in, but doing it in a very strategic way so that we can benefit those values that are most important.
We're seeing a culture change in the West about local partners, not only the water user community, the irrigators and the ag users and the municipal users, but the recreationals, the environmentalists understand now that the issue of forest health is so big and so vast that it's going to take all of us bringing all of our resources collectively and having a new approach. And that's what the Rocky Mountain Restoration Initiative is based upon. The Rocky Mountain Restoration Initiative is really built on local partners bringing what resource they can, all under the shared stewardship initiative that Sonny Perdue introduced in 2018 about shared stewardship, shared values, shared responsibilities, and shared investment, and showcasing what the Rocky Mountain Restoration Initiative can do when partners all get faced the same direction and provide a new way, a new approach to forest restoration.